Hello friends, it's me Tariq Akhtar Ansari. In this video, I'm going to show you how to upload images using REST API in Node.js. So I'll show you each and everything from basic to advanced, step by step, each and everything. So let me give you the quick demo what we are going to learn at the end of this video. So here you can see in upload folder, there is no images. Now, if I'm going to my Postman, if I'm hitting this URL and make sure you have form data. If you're trying to upload the images, you have to use the form data in Postman also. Okay. Now just select the images. Like I'm going to select this image. Okay. Now if I'll send this image, if it is success, you will get the URL to access that image. Now let me copy this URL. Control C. Now in the browser, if I'll paste this URL and hit. Now here you can see I'm able to retrieve that images. So it uploaded successfully. Let me go back again. And here you can see one image is uploaded. Okay. Now let me give you another example which I have already prepared. So in add users. So with form data, I'm sending many data like first name, last name, gender, email, password, and image also. Now let me reduce the upload size. I'll reduce this. Let me save. Okay. Now here you can see I reduced the images size. So the uploading image size is greater than the limit. Okay. Now here you can see nicely I have handled the file is too large. So you'll get this type of message. Now let me go back and increase the file size. Now if I'll remove any of the field, so let me check. So here I'm getting invalid mobile number. So I did the validations on both, even if on images and with the data. So like if everything will be the correct, then see what will happen. Now here you can see profile image. I'm getting the URL and also data is inserted into the database. One row affected. Let me go back. So here you can see I have uploaded the images successfully.
Subscribe Technical Babaji channel and press the bell icon to get the latest video updates.
Now inside this folder, I'm going to create my project from scratch. So let me open my CMD. And here I'm going to npm init minus y. So here you can see package.json is created. Now let me install two things, npm install express and multer. Okay, these two things I need. Now one more thing I need, node mon for the development. So npm install save dev as dev dependency node mon. So I have installed three packages successfully. Let me open all these in VS Code. Let me first edit in package.json. So remove this test and here let me define the start script. So start script will be node mon app.js. So I don't have app.js file. So let me create new file app.js. Okay, fine. So inside this, let me first import const express equal to require express. Now the second package we need multer require multer, and one more package I need const path equal to require path. Okay. Now initialize the express app const app equal to express. Now let me define the multer upload const upload equal to multer. So inside this we can pass there is a key destination, so we can define the destinations like dot slash upload slash images. So it will automatically create this folder. Okay, that's it. Now we can use app.post method and slash upload So here what we will do in upload dot single. If you have multiple images at a time you want to upload, then dot array method is there. Now give the name what you will take from the user, like I'm defining here profile. Okay, now make your request and response object. Response. Okay, now as of now I'm just going to print that. Okay, console.log request.file. If you're using Molter, you will get the file information in request.file. Okay, now let me listen this app.listen on port 4000 and let me give a callback console.log server up and running. So let me start npm start here. So here you can see upload folder automatically created. Now let me go back in my Postman and upload. So this is the in 4000 port number. So here is the profile. So this should be same as here, the name is profile. Okay, make sure that name should be the same, otherwise you can't upload. Now let me upload the images. Now define this profile type as file. Okay, then select the file. Here I'm selecting this file. Okay, now if I'll upload, request will be on continue because I haven't sent the response back to the client, but we'll get the log here. So in the log you can see I'm getting field name profile, original name, whatever the original name was in my system, and here you can see the file name, and this is the path where this file is updated and the size in byte. So this file size. Okay, now if you'll check, we have uploaded the file successfully, but we will not able to open this file because this file is in binary format. We cannot see. So we have two way, either we can do read and write. So from we will read the data in binary format and we'll write in .png format, then our image will be visible. But let me show you the other way of doing this. Now we can define the storage engine. Const storage equal to Molter dot disk storage. Then this has destination one key, and here I can define the same thing whatever I have defined here. Now the second thing is file name. So let me tell you guys, in server there may be a many user, they are uploading the file name, so we cannot keep the same name as in the user local system, because in server may what will happen, the other user file may get replaced because of the naming match. If name will match, then file will be replaced. So what we will do, we will create the unique name for each file which is uploading in server. So let me do that. Okay, it will take three parameters: request, file and callback. Okay, return callback with, so here we have seen the, this is the file object. Okay, so callback has always two parameters. First will be the error, second will be the result. So if we are sending the result, so we will send error null. Okay, null, and second will be the name backtick, and here request dot file dot field name. Okay, first we'll take the field name, then underscore, and we'll give second field date dot. Now so it will give the millisecond, current timestamp millisecond. Now finally we need the extension of the file. So how we'll get dollars, so I have already imported the path. So path dot e extension name. And from where we will get the extension name? From original file name. Okay, so we'll pass here request dot file dot original name. So from the original name it will automatically extract the extension and it will add. So what will be the name of our image in server? It will be the file field name. So field name is profile underscore current timestamp in millisecond, and then the file extensions whatever the user has given, like .jpg, then it will be the jpg. So always The chances is file name will be the unique in the server because current timestamp is changing every millisecond. Okay, now let's just save this and apply this into, just remove the destinations here and use storage key and apply this storage here. That's it guys. Now let me show you what will happen. Server up and running. If I'll upload the same images I'm uploading, just let me send. Request will not complete because what the error I'm getting. Sorry, I have used the request. In place of request, just use the file because already we are getting the file object here. Okay. Also remove the request from here. That's it. Just save this. Now send. It will not complete because we are not sending the response. Just let me check in the server. Now here you can see the original name and the field name. Now this is modified. So profile underscore milliseconds and .png file. If you will check in the server, now you are able to see that image. Now let me send the response back to the user with the URL so that user can also access. The first thing, we have to expose this folder, upload images, okay? app.use/profile. I'm giving the name profile. Now express.static upload/images. Okay, so it means the images folder will serve the static content, so we can access using the profile. Now how we'll send the response back to the user? Response json success colon 1 and profile URL colon, it will be http://localhost:4000s. We are running this in 4000, then /profile/then request.file.filename. So we are giving in success response. Okay, now just save this. Server up and running. Now just hit the same URL. Now here you can see I'm getting the URL to access that image. Go back here, Control V. So here you can see I'm able to access the images. Now let me show you one more thing guys. We have two more keys inside the Malter. One is filter. Now if you want to only get the file from the user like PNG images, then you can filter that. Otherwise user can update any file like .json also, user will be able to update. Now I'm not going to show filter. Now let me show you the limits. Limits is also here. Limit will take an object and it will be the file size. Like if I'm giving the file size is 10 bytes only, so if user will update more than this, we will send the error. But we are not handling error anywhere. Okay, error handler. So let me show you guys global way of handling the error. So let me define the function. It will take four parameter: error, comma, request, comma, response, comma, next. You can read out the official document of Express how to handle the global. Now inside this I'm going to catch error instance of malter.malter error. Now if this is the error, then we can send the response.json to the user with success colon 0 with message error.message. So whatever the message, now just let me send again here. File is too large, I'm getting the error, but we are not able to handle. Okay, so I haven't applied this function app.useError handler and send this. Now here you can see file is too large. So in this way we can do that, handle the error also. Now let me show you guys which I am working from last many videos on a project. So I have already built a REST API. So here you can see what I did in the user router. I have applied check token, then I have uploaded the images in the same way like I'm doing. I have already shown in this video. Now add validations I have added after this. If you'll add before, add validations, you will find request.body will be the blank. there will not be any value. But if you'll add after this, so what will happen, Multer will extract the images and whatever the information in form data, they will pass to request.body. So you'll get all this data in request.body, then you can apply the validation. So make sure guys, if you are validating the REST APIs and also uploading the images, then it should be after this, then it will work. Okay, so that's it guys in this video. Thank you for watching this video.